Welcome, everyone, to the Crystal Chronicles, the number one official and unofficial Final Fantasy Record Keeper podcast. My name is Pierre. You are listening to episode number 54, recorded on March 8, 2017. Happy Women's Day, everyone. I am with my two co-hosts. That would be Ben and Mark. Hey, guys, how much do we like women's tonight?
What an odd question. I like the women folk.
See,
about you, Mark?
I respect and appreciate women.
See how much we even had a women's theme on the show, so we are totally in sync with the International Women's Day.
Nice.
So, see what we do here. Before we get started on the show, I want to give a nod out to, I believe, our number one podcast fan, and that would be my son, Vincent, who's been listening to the podcast at school, even though he doesn't really speak English. So, give me just a second to give him a small nod in French. Salut Vincent, je sais pas si t'écoutes le podcast, mais papa dit allô, il t'aime beaucoup, puis... Voilà, j'espère que tu vas trouver le clin d'œil sympathique. So here we go. That was a quick French nod from my son. Hopefully he'll hear it. Otherwise, I just taught you a little bit of French. So right off from the press, before we get into more announcements, the Royal Archive Grintelli survey results, whatever thingy, has just been announced. And we have what people has... voted as top characters,
all right,
and Soul Breaks, and who was that that said it? Just 1 second. As Scrubby D or good old Derek said on Twitch, it's not Final Fantasy Record Keeper anymore. It should be called Final Fantasy Cloud Keeper, because the number one character, according to FFRK players, is Cloud, and nobody is surprised.
Yeah, it's pretty safe bet to think that Cloud will be the number one pick. I mean, he's everybody's first character in the game.
So, number two character is Squall, Dan Lightning, Terra, Sephiroth, Peacil, Paladin Sissel. Now, an oddball for me would be number 7 and 8, Vivi and Ramza.
We love Vivi.
I mean, Vivi is just... a black mage, so I don't know.
Whoa,
maybe
I think something goes beyond
that's
the ranking.
A bit racist.
First off, there's that. Second off, I think the ranking goes a bit beyond just the character's usability in Record Keeper.
For me, and there again, I'll say it again. I was not a Final Fantasy IX player. For me, when I look at Vivi, all I see is Final Fantasy I black mage. So that is what I meant. Yeah, I'm being ran over on the Twitch chat. That's what I meant when I said black mage. For me, Vivi is only a Final Fantasy
one. They all look the same. They all look the same to you.
I am digging myself deeper and deeper. So take it away, guys.
Sadly, my boy Waka, who I voted for, did not make the list of top characters. But you can go check that out yourself. It was just posted by the official Twitter. Actually, yes.
So more importantly, the Soul Breaks, right? Because
yes,
these Soul Breaks are going to be used to determine the banner, that free anniversary banner, correct?
Correct. And so the Overstrikes that were chosen were Clouds, Terras, Lightnings, Squalls, and my boy Titus.
All terrible.
What?
Wow.
But they're whatever. But the burst soul breaks, some decent
of them.
Yeah.
Some decent burst soul breaks. The Vessel of Fate, obviously. Asylum, very good. Then it gets worse. From there, Paladin Force, White Materia, it's the worst.
No, Asylum
and Divine,
is pretty good.
Runation.
Now, here's the thing.
That's a
super soul break. You would think that Shout would be number one, and no,
Shout,
it's number two.
Dominable Blade, it's okay, that's good.
No,
still
yeah,
useful.
Runic is really good. I want to talk briefly about, I've watched this playthrough of this Final Fantasy VI ROM hack, where the difficulty is pretty much increased, but also tons of stuff in this balanced. And pretty much, Celis is a beast because Runic is so good. And I might have to go back and play 6 again, because I don't remember using Runic that much. But maybe some people, maybe I should use it more in Final Fantasy Record Keeper. Who knows?
Derek is positioning or positing that the Japanese format was the top 4 OSBs, the top 4 BSBs, and the top 3 Super Soul Breaks will be the banner items. So that is what you have to look forward to. In your, is that Ortho Select? Is that what they called that in Japan?
Yeah, Ultra Select. Believe so. And if you look at, just one second, the... there was an image somewhere where you could see Ordos, but I can't find it anymore. But and then you've got the best abilities, and
the best
frankly,
abilities.
these are total trash. The
wow.
number one rank 5-star ability, and I kid you not, is for some random reason, Chain Firaga.
Love Chain Firaga.
Before Ultra Cure, before R5. Full Charge, and before Full Break.
Can you believe that Saints Cross didn't even make the list?
No, I can't.
Because I can't.
Yes.
What
power
the heck?
Chain. Who uses Power Chain? Seriously.
No, I use Power Chain.
Power Chain. Full Charge is still useful.
Yeah.
It is funny going down to the 4-star abilities that Rune Guz, the top ability.
Hey, listen. People got to clear out those...
I understand.
Those daily dungeons.
Protetga, Shelga, Life Siphon, Wrath. Those are pretty useful. But Runga, yeah. Well, okay. So yeah. So what's the lesson that we take from that survey?
People will select the first option they're given.
Oh, I'd be curious to see if these were first options for anything.
Yeah, I remember the survey.
I don't know. That in negotiating, that's called anchoring, where you latch on to the first option presented. So
no,
yeah.
It's called not knowing how to negotiate.
Very true. Or not know how to fill out a survey.
Well, that's true.
So all that anticipation has been met with a huge sigh of disappointment. So let's hear what else is going on in the world of Final Fantasy, Record Keeper.
Sure. Let's see. First off, there was something we announced during the last podcast last week. It was the level cap tree additions.
Yes.
Break Eiko?
Oh, yes. I broke her good.
Okay.
Rode her all the way to level 99.
That felt earlier than it should have, but sure.
Minfilia, too. I took them both up.
Your MILF's 99 now?
Yep, she's 99.
That's good.
Hey, just moving really quickly back to the survey, because this is really funny. User in Twitch, SDY, pointed out that they used the wrong image for Aerith's Wizzerod.
That is funny. Hey, whatever.
Congrats.
Oh, boy.
All right, continue with the announcements.
Yeah, you're right. It's definitely not the...
That's not it.
Let me check something real...
So do we get Apology Mithril for that?
I hope. How misleading.
You heard it here first.
That's kind of embarrassing, to
unless
be quite honest.
Unless you heard it somewhere else.
Yeah.
Unless.
Yeah, I mean, they're all rods. I mean, Seymour's rod. I mean, who knows? Whatever.
Whatever.
One rod is another rod.
You've seen one, you've seen them all.
They all look the same. Just don't, you know, text it to anybody.
Moving on.
The quiz?
Yeah, the second anniversary website is live. This is something you've probably been on if you voted or if you did the battle quiz. Did you guys do it?
I did. Yeah. This was the first mini game I actually played because I got really angry because I kept getting easy questions wrong.
Yeah, well, it's such a good thing until you realize, well, I haven't played like quarter of these Final Fantasy games. I have no flipping idea.
When they started asking questions about Crisis Core, I knew it was over, man. Yeah, yeah. My perfect streak was ruined.
Yeah, I would, you know, I would get like, you know, 10, 11 right, and then I'd get some random question like, when did Ramza's half-sister's brother-in-law's roommate come upon a bagel he found in the fridge yesterday?
It's yesterday.
How can you forget easy? That defining moment of like,
what
tactics?
What are they talking about?
Jeez. So yeah, tell us in chat if any of you guys got a perfect score.
It was out of 12, right? Or was it out of 10?
Yes, 12. It was out of 12.
Well, I think I got an 11.
I got a perfect score, but it took me 12 attempts. I knew all of the answers by that time.
I did it
over and over again, and like I would keep hitting the wrong, like, oh god damn it, I knew that, but the option changed its place, and yeah.
Nice. Yeah, pretty much.
I memorized the positioning. Oh, that was lower left. Oh, that was upper right. Oh, yeah. Crap.
What's the answer? I don't know. Lower right.
I don't know.
It's the same as going with C on multiple choice tests, you know?
Yeah, well, that's usually...
Just go with your gut.
Other than that, let's see. There was a weird foobar last night when the Torment dungeon opened. For some reason, anybody who joined that dungeon was kicked out like right away for some reason, and so they sent apology material to everyone. Now something else, and I'm reading the announcements over and over again, and I don't get it. It seems like there was an XP problem with Barrett. The XP problem you needed to have to level him up was different, and we can assume higher than the other players. Now, here's the thing I don't get. It says an error occurred on the battle results screen after completing a battle with Barrett in the party. Now, beg your pardon, but Barrett's been in the game for a long time. Are you telling me if you had Barrett in your party, you shit out of the game every time and nobody realized that before?
I guess nobody thought to bring Barrett. That's, yeah.
Nobody's been using Barrett.
Or maybe they just thought it was...
Well, I hadn't been using him until I got his Tetra break, so... break.
Crap. We'll talk about that. But that's really weird. It's so strange how it'd be character-specific. Dang.
Yeah, for real. But anybody on Twitch, if you've been Barretted out of the game, let us know, and let us know when it happened. Because I'm fairly sure some people probably realize, holy hell, I have Barrett in my party. I never even realized I had him. Because, Barrett, who cares?
I got all kinds of brakes on that guy and a gun arm.
Yeah, he's the only one who can use it, along with Tyro for some
reason. Hey, Tyro? Tyro's willing to cut his arm off and replace
just... it. it'll grow back. It's just a flesh wound. Oh, jeez.
There was this weird-ass commercial when I was young. It was... I don't know if you have this in the United States. War MPDs or something. You know, people missing limbs, but it's some kind of public organization. Let me see what's the name in English.
We have veterans who are without limbs, yes?
No, but it's called Les Amputés de Guerre in French. Let me see what's the name in English. It probably has an English website somewhere. English, it's called the War Amps. Does that ring a bell?
No.
Okay, anyway, the commercial was this weird-ass robot just moving in a 3D scene of blades and saws and all of that, and he would get an arm chopped off. And at the end of the commercial, he would say, I can put my arm back on. You can't. Play safely.
What the heck?
So I guess Tyro can say the same thing.
Wow. That's something.
Let me post the link on Twitch. Just one second.
Sure thing.
Yeah, it was really, really, nice. Really weird. I got it. There it is. Let me post that on Twitch. Real quick, and so I can. So these were the commercials. So look at it, and I imagine that that's Tyro, probably. Just like,
whoa, that's really scary.
Yeah, but how wait till the end.
I'm scared. How are you gonna have?
I'm gonna post.
I'm scared.
The YouTube link in the show notes, by the way.
Thanks, Pierre. Now I'm gonna have nightmares about my arm being chopped off and reattached.
Yeah, but he can put it back and you can't, so play safely.
I know! I'm scared! Oh, jeez.
These were the commercial in Canada when you were young. That's what we had to live up with. No wonder we all messed up.
No wonder, man.
I think all Mark right. died what? From that commercial.
On Earth did I just watch?
That's what I'm that's
Canadian
what I'm
commercials.
What?
That was like a weird Metropolis.
I know.
PSA. I mean,
at least it left a strong impact.
I mean, you couldn't just have somebody who, you know, had lost a limb and be like, "Hey,
yeah,
I served my country. You know, do me a solid.
Do me a solid.
Do
dude.
Me a solid. Give me an arm.
Don't lose an arm.
Right."
I lost an arm for you. Do me a solid. Give me your arm. All right.
How about we move on?
Let's move on to the Final Fantasy VII event. When you vow upon a star, maybe Sephiroth one kill Aerith. So, what's new in there? There's a new guy called Rufus. He doesn't bring his dog, but he his panther, but he brings to the table white magic 4, combat 4. Support 4-star, darkness 5, and sharp shot 5-star. So he's a gun using Jack, pretty much.
Yeah, except he doesn't. He's like one of the first gun users to not have mechanist abilities, which
is
pretty.
Is that how you say it? Because I know some people like to
I don't know.
Get mad
like,
at
listen,
us.
Listen, I've given up at this point. As long as it starts with M and ends in IST, I'm happy, you know?
So it probably hurts them when we say it. But seriously, though, did you guys
plan
on using
Rufus?
Well,
if they're not mechanists, who are making the mechs? That's all I'm saying.
That's what I'm talking about. Anyway, I don't have any plans to use Rufus. I just have so much better gear for other...
It's machinist.
It's
machinist.
That's so stupid, though.
Machinist.
So stupid.
That's
like they're making parts for an assembly line. We're the machinists.
Well, you know, I guess Rufus is the president, so he wouldn't be the one making the machines. So it holds up. Anyway, if you take a look in Rufus's newly unlocked,
it comes from mech because they have mechs. They're No, it's actually comes from machinations.
Yeah,
they're machinists.
That's
my argument.
Well, Oxprit on Twitch says, yeah, it comes from machine, not mechanic.
Fine, I'll say mechanist.
It is machinist is how it's spelled, but that's ridiculous and stupid.
I've always said mechanist, and until that very moment, I never realized that it was actually something else. So there you go.
Anyway, we don't need to worry about pronouncing it because Rufus doesn't have those kinds of abilities.
Yeah.
However, in his spheres, you can get a whole lot of stats down the Dark Knight and Beastmaster. Oh, that's funny, Beastmaster, because he has this dog. Spheres, and if you go down the Cannoneer sphere, you could get 3% gun damage and 6% sharpshooter ability damage.
So he's an Irvine that doesn't suck.
He's Irvine with a bit more very.
He's not Irvine because Irvine has support 5.
Yeah,
oh, that's right. I thought you could unlock support 5 with the spheres. Sorry, my mistake.
So yeah, that's Rufus.
You guys planning on using him?
No.
No. Not until I get all of the Turks, and then I can get my Turk team all
set.
Yeah,
pretty much.
Yeah, that's
I need some
be a
Elena.
Thing, right? They're going to be adding the rest of some more Turks.
Well, we don't even have Rude yet, so, I mean, what's up with that?
Yeah, Rude, Combat 4, and Combat 4. Combat 5 and Combat 5.
No one's arguing that it's machinist. It's just stupid. That's what we're saying. We know how it's pronounced.
We've given up.
For those wondering why Mark just had an old man moment, it's because Super Cop just posted some pronunciation for Machinus on Twitch.
Look at this Merriam-Webster. Get out of here, nerd.
All right. Other than the Rufus, we've got a new accessory. It's Tifa's earring. It gives you attack 15 and moderate resistance to stop. Other than that, we've got, and I'd like to check the wording on that one, because I don't trust Mark 1 second with his outline.
What?
Yeah. So we have a new wardrobe record. It's Tifa's leather suits and not Tifa's puppy sweater.
That's not what's written in the outline.
I'm sorry. New wardrobe record, Tifa's puppy sweater.
There we go.
I can't handle you guys.
So explain that one, puppy sweater. I don't get it.
Well, she's, Tifa grew up and she's got to keep the ladies covered a little bit better than she used to. You know, wearing the tube top and the suspenders.
But what about
she's a little bit more respectable.
I'm a fan of the cowboy outfit from Crisis Core that makes an appearance in World of Final Fantasy. But,
I'm not familiar with that.
Let me get a picture.
I will see a picture
of Final. I'll get a World of Final Fantasy.
See, I just Googled puppy sweater and I still don't get it. Because all of these puppies have shirts but no
puppies.
Pants.
Her puppies. Puppies. You know, the puppies.
From the most trusted news source, Crunchyroll. That's chibi-fied, but that is Tifa in her cowboy outfit that she shows up in Crisis Core while she's still training in the ways of martial arts.
That's chibi.
Yeah.
Like that looks like something my daughter would find cute. She's 7, by the way.
Yeah. I'm sure that's the demographic they were aiming for.
Boobs are called puppies. So I apologize.
There you go. I'm glad we got that cleared up.
That cultural misunderstanding.
I feel really, really stupid right now. It was probably one of these moments where someone bashed their head against their steering. Until
their steering wheel. Oh, jeez. Like, don't do that.
For Christ's sake. So, yeah, we just lost a viewer because he died as he did that.
He's just dang.
Dang. We've just killed many people.
All right.
I've got that blood on my hands now.
Nice.
Moving on. I did some ultimate battles. I promised I'd get back in the game. I got back in the game.
What? And,
I know. So for a change, I'm going to have an idea what the hell we're talking about. I did Ultimate Plus, and I got wiped out really hard on 2 Plus, but at least I tried. So, Mark, take the wheel and tell us about the Ultimate Battles.
Ultimate Battle Ends of Madness, where we fight Heretic Hojo, who evolves into Lifeform Hojo-N, who evolves into Raichu. No, wait, that's a different... different note, sorry. So you need to defeat the left arm or the body of Heretic Hojo, and then he evolves into Lifeform Hojo-N. Heretic Hojo uses AOE bio attacks and can confuse and sleep.
Clarify that, if you didn't read Mustax and you beat Heretic Mojo and you're already celebrating and he comes back from the death, that's because, as I just said, you didn't read Mark's text and you didn't read Mark's text and you didn't listen to Mark because he comes back. He didn't win yet.
Yes.
Yeah,
you have to meet two enemies.
Yeah, I didn't read Mark's text.
Two enemies.
You were doing the victory dance in real life. I was
in the subway like, bup, 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 bup. Oh, shit.
Well, I can't imagine you doing that.
When he evolves or transitions, he casts an AoE blind and silent attack, so bring protection versus those ailments on your favorite characters. Once he evolves, he moves mainly to physical, but he does have some status attacks, so watch out for those. Not too bad, however.
Yeah, pretty easy. It wasn't a very, very tough fight.
I'm on it right now. I got my boy Laguna shooting some missiles.
What about the Ultimate Plus, a struggle for freedom?
Well, it was a struggle
Rufy
for
and
champion
the Dark Nation.
Here.
Yeah.
Yeah, but what I kind did of name? Submission it on for show. What kind of name? What?
What kind of name is Dark Nation for a dog? Like that's even Intercept. Even Interceptor is a better name. I mean, come on.
Just imagine outside in the park. Dark Nation, do your poopies, your Dark peepees. Nation. Come on, Dark Nation.
Dark Nation, Dark. Play nice.
Darky. Woof woof.
Dark Nation. It's like too much of a mouthful for an animal.
Like that. Well, I don't think it's an animal so much as it is a horrible mutated.
Yeah, it's like a
he still gave it a name. Ben, what's your dog's name?
Oh, my dog's name is Ginger, and she is currently locked in the box for being too loud.
Did you poke holes in the box?
She's in her crate. What are you? Okay. You guys are sick.
Well, you
what
said you locked doing? In the box because she was making too much noise.
Well, that implies that she can't just push the door open.
It's a cage, she can make just as much noise.
Well, no, she knows to stay quiet in the box. Anyway, can we...
The box.
Is that like a penalty box, like in hockey? It's like 2 minutes in the box. Shut up.
In the box.
Yeah, it's just like that.
So anyway, my point was that even if it was like an horrible monster, it's named Ginger. It has an animal name. It's not named like Dark Nation or some stuff. So it's a weird name.
You're right.
So Rufus and Fluffy... Fluffy casts haste. Fluffy casts haste and can slow and dispel you, and has less health. So focus on Fluffy first. Rufus has self haste, so dispel is helpful against that. He uses all physical attacks, but his deadliest attacks ignore defense. So break his attack as much as possible. And if you have the penta break on our friend Barrett, that will help. Considerably. Rufus does some fire-based damage, so if you're struggling, you could throw on some fire-resistant gear. That brings us to the Cid mission. You likely have some Final Fantasy VII relics, because...
Every third Final event Fantasy is a Final VII. Fantasy VII event.
Hooray!
So, you probably have more than one option. You have a lot of options in general in Final Fantasy VII. Remember, Zack can use Power Chain and Full Charge. Cid can use the Dragoon combo. Yuffie can use Mug Bloodlust. Barret can and Kaith can Break or Dance, respectively. Aerith is your healer, and there are several mage options and other physical attacker options. Cid now has Shout as a Super Soul Break, which is very, very helpful. And Cloud has a new shiny BSB. So lots of different options. You could probably do it without much of a battle in terms of relics. But to let you know what I had a lot of relics. I have Cloud's BSB-1, his crappy BSB. I have Zack's new BSB, the Imperial Wind BSB. I have Shout on Cid. I have the Penta Break on Barret. And I have a Super Soul Break on Aerith, the re-raise one, I believe. So that was my team. And we were able to do that pretty easily. So, good luck. Good luck. That brings us to Ultimate Plus Plus Final Encounter and the Ultima Weapon. You have 13 turns until Ultima Weapon uses Ultimate Shadow Flare and you lose. So this is a DPS check. Make sure to bring plenty of magic mitigation and protection since most of his attacks are magic, but he also has a single target physical attack. Ultima Beam ignores resistance, so be prepared for that. I strongly advise a Medica Roaming Warrior if you can make that work. I actually brought my Cid team on all three of these ultimate battles and defeated it all three times with my Cid team. Unfortunately, Cloud continued to die, I think, in that final fight. Yes, Cloud, if you look on my Twitter, is face down on the floor because he seemed to get targeted by that random attack where he like does three attacks randomly and it's supposed to be random who he hits. He seemed to single target Cloud with that attack over and over and over again until Cloud was dead. And so Cloud died and Zack and Cid did and Barrett and Aerith did the rest of the work. So then Zach did most of it. But, all right. So not too hard if I was able to do it with the Sid team, even a decent Sid team. So there you go. That brings us to banners, and I know I pulled on banner one, as many other people did.
I did too. I pulled on this banner on the drive home from break. A friend was giving me a ride since we both live around the same area, and I pulled Cloud's BSB2, and I got very excited. And he said, "What happened?" And I'm like, "Oh, I got the item," and he had no idea what it was. Well, you know, so, I was happy none the same, all the less.
If it's just me, it's the first time they add a character, and that character has no item on the first Relic Draw banner. Am I correct?
Yeah, it's kind of hilarious, actually, yeah.
Okay, so
it wasn't just me. Rufus. Yeah, Rufus's one and only relic shows up on the second banner, which we will get to. But this first banner features our first USB.
Which oddly enough, was not like announced really. Like, usually they make a whole lot out of it. I mean, they even made announcements like new feature, blah blah blah, for some random crap. But
yeah, but they're just basically Super Soul Breaks that are better.
Yeah, but that one was still on higher stats. It kind of went under the radar for some reason.
Well, but it even looks. Yeah. I mean, if you look at the little pictures for the Ultimate Soul Breaks. They're basically just a Super Soul Break with another little plus sign. So yeah, it's not even like a unique thing. Much. It's just a... I mean, they even recognize that this is just a better Super Soul Break.
Oh, mm-hmm. I know, but you'd think they'd... All right, how is it, Ben? Let us know.
So, Hidden Bloom for Aerith is a instant medica, which are always great, and it also gives Shelga, and it gives a 2,000 HP... I guess back pool of health, which is really good. So you use this when you're in a tight spot, you heal up all the way, and then you still got a bit of a buffer until you have to heal up again. It's really good. I mean, if this was a Super Soul Break, it'd be a really good Super Soul Break. But it's an Ultra Soul Break, which doesn't really mean anything other than the fact that it's under a 6-star item. So that's good.
It's our first umbrella. I mean,
oh yeah, a huge milestone. Is there a recurring theme of umbrellas being joke weapons? I know, like, in JRPGs in general, because I remember in a Kingdom Hearts for the DS game, there is a umbrella joke weapon. But I'm trying to think of others. Anyway, this is no joke. The umbrella has pretty good has really good stats, so it's good with any healer. Now we move on to the Ultima Blade for Cloud, his second BSB. Wow, and the head honchos at DNA thought, what should we do for Cloud's BSB 2? Should we have it be Omnislash? Nah. So Cloud Cycle is 8 physical winds and non-elemental attacks to one target and infuse the user with the power of wind. It's essentially Klim Hazard plus Fenrir Overdrive. So you can save some spots on your... Since you're only limited to 4 Soul Breaks, such huge decisions on which ones you want to bring, even though you're probably just going to be using one. But yeah, this definitely out-DPSs... Fenrir Overdrive, since that one is the first Soul Break ever introduced. This one is a lot better. The commands are combat type. Well, then they're pretty standard, except they have base damage dependent on the user's base attack, which is nice. But, you know, it's your standard 4 hits of single, 2 hits of all. But yeah. It's definitely good, and it has a unique sprite in battle, which is always cool to see. We can move right along to Sid's Burst Soulbreak weapon, the Viper Halberd with the Burst Soulbreak Dragon Dive, not Dragoon Dive. And it is 10 jump, their jump type, so keep in mind, I don't know, there are some gimmick fights in which jump is not allowed, But it's 10 jump wind attacks to one target, and it infuses the user with power of wind. And this is another one of those types that this is a, one of those types of soul breaks which deal more hits if the target has a weakness or slight weakness to wind or to an element. So arrow boost normally does 4 to one target, but it does 5 if there's a weakness, and wind force normally deals 2, but if there's a weakness it does 3. And these are type combat, they're not type dragoon, the burst commands. So yeah. Meteor shots for Zach is old. Here we go. We have everybody's favorite, Barrett's gun arm, the heavy Vulcan. Something about chopping off your arm?
That
don't do it.
Very useful weapon for your entire team.
Yeah. I'm not sure if you're supposed to chop off your arm or not. I'm too scarred by the creepy bug robot.
I don't know what the message of the video was.
It's a
well. It's also it's because it was my arm. You can't play safely. The message
Darn.
Was clear.
Be careful, kids, when you're jumping through buzzsaw obstacle courses.
What kind of example is that? Anyway, hyper grenade bomb is your classic penta break, and it's actually fire elemental. So,
well, it's a bomb.
Use it. Yeah.
Bonus.
Well, flare is non-elemental. Explain that.
It's
you can't.
Not a bomb.
What? How is a flare not a bomb, Pierre?
Because it's a flare.
Play safe. No, I have no idea.
Whatever.
Play safe flares, people. They're non-elemental. Yes, France BS threats on Twitch. France BSB is better. Because it's a BSB. Oh, yeah. Hyperbreak.
What?
That does make it better.
Just threat talking about comparing it to Barrett's or to yes. Sid's first soul.
The heavy Vulcan compared to the new Franz weapon we just got. Franz is actually a BSB as opposed to just a super soul break. So
okay.
Franz is the only BSB hyper break we have. We have Irving and Barrett super soul break hyper breaks.
So. All right, well, those are the only 4 new relics on this banner. To round it out, we have Sid's Javelin, Sephiroth's Glove, Sid's Goggles, and the Prism Rod, which I also got on this banner. Fury Brand, it's whatever. Critical hit chance is a nice little bonus to add. Also, it's Magic Blink. But, yeah, that is this. That's this first banner. Now, I guess we'll move right along to the second one, featuring Tifa's Overstrike, which is Meteor Strike.
Now, take a moment and look at that glove and try to imagine how unpractical it would be to have a weapon like that on your arm.
What are you talking about? The rockets make your punches stronger. That's basic science.
Then it rips your entire arm off.
Not if you're strong enough to withstand it. Pierre, have you never used a rocket glove?
I try not to, but try to imagine how it's going to burn your shoulder right off. And then she's got long hair, so obviously it's going to burn her hair as well.
Listen, I don't need to explain rocket-powered fists.
Yeah.
Well, to be fair, by the time of Advent Children, her gloves were a lot more streamlined.
Oh, yeah, then they were just classic. So yeah, Meteor Strike, it is one big ol' Earth attack. And the head honchos at DNA said, should we make Tifa's Overstrike Final Heaven? And then they said, nah. Why would we do that? Moving right along, we have Vincent's Burst Soulbreak weapon. He also has got a pair of gloves. His super cool, edgy, fingerless gloves. I didn't even notice that. That's really funny. And that is Galleon Beast. And this is a stat-dependent attack, which is really good. 6 physical or magic fire and non-elemental attacks to all targets.
and it grants all allies a barrier that reflects damage, so that's pretty good. The burst abilities are both darkness type, and there is Claws of the Damned, which deals 4 physical fire and non-elemental attacks to one target, and it deals more damage if the user has Doom. And there's Howl of the Dam, which is AoE, and it also deals more damage if the user has Doom. So these are really good. So obviously you're going to want to use a darkness ability to inflict Doom on yourself before you activate this burst. Soulbreak. Sorry. Yeah, it seems pretty good, especially against enemies weak to fire. Now we move on to Red 13's Platinum Barrette, which gives the burst soul break Cosmo Canyon. And what was Red 13's? Red 13 limit breaks. What was his final one? Was it Cosmo Memory?
No idea. To the moon? I don't know.
We've got all kinds more time and different, you know, super hyper ultra burst breaks.
That's true. I should
you don't want to blow all your final weapons all at once.
That's true. Even though, no, you're completely right. I am right. The final limit break for Red 13 is called Cosmo Memory, but that's not this. This is Cosmo Canyon, which raises the attack and magic ball allies a moderate amount, granting them major regen and haste and burst mode to the user.
Poor man's Onion Knight.
Well, yeah, but also this is more support based. So the burst abilities are Steel Break Howl, which reduces a target's defense a large amount, Stone Fang, which reduces a target's resistance a large amount. So pretty good for getting through some tough walls. All right. And is that it? Nope, there's one more new Soulbreak on this banner. It is Rufus's Mako Barrage. Says, I've got a shotgun. And has another... Nope, I stopped myself. I assumed just because it's a gun that it is a Tetra Break, but that is simply not true. Mako Barrage
deals Peril Darkness.
Yep, Mako Barrage deals 6 ranged physical dark, non-elemental attacks of all targets, lowers their resistance to dark, and it deals more damage when facing fewer enemies. That's pretty cool. Have we seen anything?
We've had that. Yeah, we've had that before.
Yeah, but it was contrary.
On 4 enemies.
No,
yeah.
we just had one in the 12 event.
Really?
That did the same thing. When you're doing less enemies, it does more damage.
All right. Well, I guess that's a call out to Rufus's one-on-one fight with Cloud.
Yeah.
Yeah. I guess so.
He knows how to do it.
Anyway, rounding out the banner, we have Tifa's Oversoul, Vincent's Short Barrel, Yuffie's Crystal Cross. Do I have that? Yeah, I do have that. And Red 13's Crystal Comb. And the Prism Rod again for Aerith. So all in all, both these banners are... Finally, we're getting some okay 7 banners. Definitely, I think the first one's better, just because Hidden Bloom is really good as a medica. And, I mean, if you've been playing the game for as long as I have, which is since launch, you're going to have some relics for Cloud. But if it's time for an upgrade in terms of burst soul breaks, and Cloud Cycle is that upgrade. I especially like the part at the end where he twirls his sword around before placing it on his back. I like that part of the animation a lot. But, yeah. All in all, it all depends on which characters you want to use. But, yeah. I think I'm going to put in 5 Mithril on the second banner. Let's see what I got.
As you do that, I'm currently sitting on 230 mithril, still haven't pulled from...
What?
I know.
What?
231, exactly.
Yeah, we were having some conversations on Slack chat, and who is it that has, like, over 1,000 mithril?
Wow.
Jeez.
I think Schwarzkopf may have like 600, but somebody on Twitch remind me somebody has like over 1,000 mithril. I'm forgetting.
Supercop.
Yes, it is Supercop. Supercop has over a thousand mithril.
So Supercop, you're on Twitch. Why are you sitting a 1,000 mithril? I mean, I'm doing it so that Derek can't make fun of me because I caved and I pulled. But why are you holding on so many mithril? Why?
Tell us.
Waiting for the wave.
So Ben, did you
win
anything?
No.
So that's why you went silent.
You know, I have every single stat boosting item on cloud right now, so you know it's all good. Wait, that means he has a total of plus 40 attack. Holy
probably
moly!
Still less than Onion Knight. So weird.
Well,
less than Zach.
What do you mean, just in terms of raw attack value?
It's still quite a bit lower, isn't it? That depends on how bursted you are.
The character
What's your unequipped cloud?
Well, let's see. I don't have cloud cycle mastered yet, but
my unequipped cloud is 230.
Let's see. I gotta remove all this. It's gonna be around.
That's without synergy, right?
Yeah, that's unequipped.
At level 99.
I'm at level 99.
I'm at 249, and I still haven't maxed out his level 1 spheres, which I'm going to do right now. Da 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 da. So yeah, I'll have around 250 base attack. Not too shabby.
Pretty good.
All right. Let's move on to the multiplayer battles. The first one is the Turks. So it's the usual battles against the three Turks. You only have to kill one. It's not...
Kill Reno.
Yeah.
Kill Reno.
Because Stupid Reno. So it's really nothing to talk about. You can easily solo that one. Then Sephiroth at...
Sephiroth!
Okay. 160 and 300 battle. Mark, did you do it?
I have not done these two yet. I have been fairly busy these last couple of days, so I've not done this. But I can tell you a lot of people are doing it, not having really... any issue, but unlike the last time we did Sephiroth, he is able to get past Draw Fire Retaliate with many of his attacks. The last time we faced him, you could basically Draw Fire Retaliate most of his attacks.
Oh yeah, I saw people soloing the crap out of him.
Yeah, there's only one or two of his attacks now that are actually susceptible to that. So still may be worth bringing it, but it's not like every attack. So he has a lot of attacks that ignore taunt. So just keep that in mind.
So don't
use your good powers.
Noted.
Break his attack over and over and over and over and over and over and over again.
So you set lots of breaks, some healing death prevention to deal with his instant KO attack, an attack that reduces you to 1 HP.
Oh, yeah, he's got fun attacks, yeah.
He counters with self-haste, so lots of dispel strike if you are worried about it. So obviously, if you die, just blame it on somebody else in the multiplayer game.
Pretty much.
Yeah, that's usually how it works. Moving on, Torment Dungeon with the three ugly giants from Final Fantasy II. Do you guys have a chance to do this? Wow, no, not you yet. Are tired tonight.
Jeez. I've not had the chance to tackle this Torment Dungeon. I do not know who I would bring along. Well, I guess I could bring along anybody.
Bring your Final Fantasy II sit team.
Oh, if yeah. You have one? I would bring Desh.
Yeah.
And Maria. And yeah. That's it.
Yeah, that's enough. You're gonna just bring the two of them.
I mean, those are the only two Final Fantasy II characters that I have equipment for.
Yeah.
That's enough.
You're going to be dinned on dead really shortly.
Well, I'd bring other people. I just don't know who.
So, do we have advice for our listeners?
Don't die.
Okay. People on Twitch, we are listening for your advice. And by the way, you're being corrected on Twitch. Dash is a Final
Dash
Fantasy
is from 3
character.
From Final Fantasy 3.
I'm exposed.
Maria BSB, it would be nice to have. Of course, it's nice to have Maria's BSB anyway, because it's one of the best BSBs.
So we I've just killed a second listener that just banged his head on the steering wheel tonight with your Final Fantasy 2 Dash.
You know what? It's okay, because I have Leon's Darkborn or Defender that I got from, I think, the Choice. Yeah, the Keeper's Choice Volume 1 banner.
I've seen people do, you know, Mage Team. I've seen people use AoE. I've seen people use Physical Elemental. It seems like people are having a lot less issue with this one than other ones. Obviously, most people are bringing Dancer abilities, Shelga, Protetga, Multi-Break, the Magic Breakdown Dance, using their Gigas Armlets. We have two of those, I think, if you've been playing since the beginning. Other elemental absorbing accessories.
All right.
Yeah. All right. A lot of mage teams. That seems to be pretty common in the Torment Dungeons, bringing those mage teams. Your best mage team.
So
doing the heavy damage if you got the god level mage BSBs.
All right. Let's move on to discussions. Now, I know we have some topics, but real quick, this is International Women's Day. So let's do an ad lib. Preferred female character in all Final Fantasy. What is yours? Wow, really?
No, like, I'm trying to think.
There are ladies.
I saw a really good tweet about Final Fantasy V, which was you start the game with a party of three. Men.
I think you just got in there because that was horrible.
We edited that one. We had to cough button him.
What?
It was a 5 second delay. People, it was bad.
Yeah, you caught. Seriously, you caught, and all we heard is I saw this tweet. You start with a party of three, and then you went silent.
Yeah, it got real bad after that. People, we had to cut. Yeah, you cut out.
Okay, the tweet was, you start with a party of three men and a token princess. You end the party with you end the game with a party of three princesses and a token guy. So,
good times.
That's Final Fantasy V for you.
Yeah, we had an interesting discussion about Final Fantasy V.
I'll retweet it
on Slack this week. So,
but favorite female character.
I said Rinoa last week is probably my favorite character in the game. I like Rinoa quite a bit.
Let me say it another way. Favorite female hero and favorite female villain.
Ooh.
For me, I think it would be Lightning and Ilya.
Wow, I'm gonna stop myself. That's people can like different things.
Wow, what's wrong?
Nothing.
Edie is kick ass. She's
no, Edie is cool. Anyway, favorite character. I really like Ash, just because how determined she is through the story.
Boo.
What are you doing?
The mask and hot pants. Boo.
Nothing to do with her design.
I like Aerith because she gets killed with a sword.
Wow.
Yeah, anyway. I really like Yuna. I really like Rinoa. I like Aranea. Is she a villain? Can she be my favorite villain? New favorite villain? She's kind of a villain hero. Frenemy. She a frenemy? Can she be my frenemy?
Oh, thank you, Schwartz.
Aranea.
Thank you. I'm glad to see someone appreciates.
Oh, Ash.
Wow. Unreal.
All right.
Transform Terra. Yeah, it's half woman. Half Esper.
Oh, yeah. Transform Terra. Terra's kick ass, too. She
oh, yeah.
Terra.
Oh, yeah.
Terra. They're great.
While watching that stream. Beatrix.
So, Beatrix, does she fit in as a villain? Because she's not really a villain. I mean,
yeah,
she's right hurted.
She's kind of like Aranea in 15. She's a frenemy.
Yeah,
it's kind of hard to argue.
You fight her.
It's hard to argue with why she's fighting with you.
Yeah.
Yeah. You know.
Is Beatrix in that Final Fantasy fighting game they're making?
You mean Dissidia?
Yeah.
No, not yet.
I think so, yeah.
I wish. That'd be really cool.
Is that thing ever going to be released, or?
Nope. Doesn't seem like it.
Oh, what a shame. Okay, moving on. The other discussion topics we have. Well, first off, we had the Crystal Chronicle Slack giveaway by Australian Derek. And the winner was Oodle. And,
Oodle!
Don't miss an episode of the Crystal Chronicles for future giveaway.
You'll never know when we're going to give away giveaways. So thank you, Derek, for sponsoring that giveaway and being the one to host that giveaway. And congratulations, Oodle. Hopefully you will get oodles of 5-star relics on your polls in the anniversary selections.
And even if you
see
don't.
See what I did there? That was a...
Even if you don't get tons of relics, you can rest assured knowing that it's not your money being spent.
Well, there you go.
Yeah.
Okay, but now, a question from Mitron. If you had to pick a Final Fantasy world from 1 to 15 to live in after it's been saved, which world would you pick and why? This includes all class, job, magic, base abilities at your disposal, and leftover enemy problems to deal with after the plot ends?
It's a good question.
It's a good
that
question.
That is a good question.
I would probably pick Final Fantasy VI because it's like not super futuristic, but not like medievally.
Wow, really?
Yeah. Final Fantasy VI would be it.
But post game?
All right.
Yeah.
But that's after, like, Kefka tore a freaking line through the world.
Yeah,
I guess it seems okay.
Yeah, I mean, you've got a world to rebuild. It's not like super.
You got stuff to do. You know,
you're right.
Got a job. You're going to be employed.
So I'm torn between the world of Final Fantasy VIII because there's internet and electricity, and Ivalice, probably from 12, just because holy moly, that is chill AF. Yeah, seems like a really chill world to just be like a traveling merchant in, you know? And like the monsters, was it even brought up that like because of the Nethesite, monsters have gone on the rise, or is it just not monsters part of the, you know, general
monsters were just part of the
No, yeah. That's
I mean,
funny.
There were evil Nethesite creations, but I think
Yeah. But none that were just roaming around.
Yeah, I think 7, 13 are pretty messed up. I mean, obviously,
Advent
Children.
That wouldn't be my answer, that's for
post-game,
sure.
Post-game, 13 even was... you know, Ivalice in 12, I think, is a great world, because it really doesn't change.
Yeah.
I mean, there's really... I mean, yes, there's a big Sky Fortress, and all that, but really, at the end of the day, the world is mostly untouched.
Oh yeah, there's no real like mass
and so
genocides.
There's really no difference, like, you know, the 12 or like 10, you know, completely different world, right? Before and after the game.
I
love Final Fantasy VIII, and I like that world a lot, but I think it'd be fun. I think Final Fantasy XII is kind of that cool high fantasy, you know, be a sky pirate kind of thing. So it's either be mercenaries in a floating high school or be sky pirates in Ivalice. So,
dude, forget mercenary. I'm gunning for the top triple triad player.
Triple triad champion. That would be, and since I couldn't, you know, couldn't be with Renoa because Squall's got that, I'd have to get in with Quistis. So.
Okay, before this changes to an entirely different
Before we move on, for what I've played of it, I think I would probably also settle for the Teru Teru village in Final Fantasy XI. That place is chill. That place is just like...
Well, that's what I think Trinity was saying on Slack chat. There were several conversations on Slack chat around this topic, but she was like, well, after the calm, after Final Fantasy X ends... You know, it'd be like a nice place to like hang out on the beach and, you know, watch some Blitzball and, you know, there's some, you know, like probably some weed. I mean, it's just kind of like a chill world after everything. You know, there's no monsters, you know, sin's gone. It's just, drinking mixed drinks with Waka on the beach. So,
yeah, but I was talking about 11, not 10.
No, I'm just saying that kind of thing would be true of 10.
Oh,
it'd be more like a vacation. That's not what I was thinking. I was thinking like Final Fantasy X would be kind of boring because there's no monsters. There's nothing to do. I'd have to kill Waka because, you know.
Because Waka. You'd have to raise this kid out of guilt, and that's not much better.
Yeah, we'd take care of that too. So. Send him off to Bleedsball Camp.
Bleedsball Academy for you.
Still in diapers. Ben, you wanted to move on.
Oh, I mean, if you no, it sounds like you guys are having a blast. You know,
we're around the Teru Teru campfire, just with, you know, cooking.
Oh wait, no, I changed my answer. Crystal Chronicles for the GameCube. Oh,
Crystal Chronicles.
I didn't play that one. What was so good about it?
Oh my god, first of all, if I could just hear the music 24/7, I'd be okay with it, you know? That game's soundtrack. Woof.
I want to go into the Final Fantasy 15 world with my bros.
Oh yeah, you got full electricity there. You got cars.
They have cell phones. They have cell phones.
Yeah.
Smartphones.
It's true.
I don't know shit about that game except noodles, and that's your fault, Ben.
Yeah, they got
cup noodles. That's right. That's all I need.
Cup noodles.
Get there.
But I wouldn't want to go, unless, you know, because the other three are hanging around. I'd like to go pre-game. You know, if I could hang out with my bros in Final Fantasy 15.
Oh, post-time skip, yeah. Or pre-time skip.
Yes, N45800. Post 10 would be 10-2, which is why I would not want to live there.
Oh, then you'd have to listen to all the terrible J-pop. Oh, jeez, no.
it would be a terrible, terrible, terrible place.
So, what's the draw of the week?
Draw of the week. Oh, we had Derek. Got a 100 gem Tifa OSB. Congratulations.
Nice.
Purple Nep Nep got Cloud and Zax BSB. I think he just said that again in Twitch. So in one banner, so that's very good. Congratulations. I think those are our draws of the week. I got five stars, which is exciting. So,
and it didn't make it trash a draw of the week?
No. But, you know, it was good.
All right.
I'm not complaining.
And besides my 3-star 100 gem and 3-star free pull that I got on the same day, what else is crap of the week?
There was a lot of Prism Rod draws. There was a lot of 1 for 11 Prism Rod. So I didn't write down anybody's name in particular, but I did catch a few of those over the course of the week. So sorry.
Yeah, I got a five.
A lot of that was several people who pulled, you know, more than once. There were several people that pulled quite a few times on this banner. So at some point, you're bound to get a dud.
I got a 5 Mithril Prism Rod. So, I mean, hey, it's not the worst thing you could get.
It's not the worst thing you could get.
I agree.
Like a smack in the face.
I'd be really impressed if by paying 5 Mithril, I got smacked.
Dysentery? That would be bad.
Oh, yeah.
You've died.
All of a sudden, the game turns into Oregon Trail. You got a hunt. It's just Rufus with his shotgun.
That would be fun. I'd play that.
That'd be great.
Rufus Trail.
Oh my
Rufus
god, someone make an Oregon Trail mod where it's the Shinra Trail. That'd be amazing.
Post Final Fantasy VII, the Turks and Rufus, like in a covered wagon.
Oh my god, I need to play that right now.
There you go, people. Hard. There you go, Square, if you're listening.
Shinra.
Your next new great game, mobile next app.
$60 AAA title.
Shinra Trail.
All right.
Bring along Dark Nation.
Yeah.
Round up the buffalo for you. Can't wait to get to the raft part. My favorite.
Yeah. It just turns into the raft segment from 6.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Left, left, right, right.
Right? I don't know. All right.
Let's move on to Japanese Week in Review. So from Australian Derek, hope you've had another awesome week killing some Torment Gigas and drawing some excellent Final Fantasy VII relics. We've had another eventful week in the Japanese version of the game with bonus collabs sneaking in the event release schedule and with a little tease of what's coming up. Let's check it out. Launch of Final Fantasy VII event, Dirge of Cerberus. Introduction of Shalky, Support 5, Celerity 5, Mechanist 4, and Combat 3. No new ability, and yeah, new USB, BSB, LM. Launch of the Final Fantasy Legend 2 collaboration, The Door Beyond Time. Wait a second, is that the old Game Boy game?
What?
Is that what it is? Holy, that can't be the old Game Boy game.
Door.
Yeah, I'm looking right now, and it's giving me the old.
Wow, like Final Fantasy Legend, I think it's called.
Yeah, and I played that when I was a kid. That's how I learned part of my English. But they can't really have done an event with that.
I think. How crazy will that be?
Wow, seriously? Okay, sorry. So someone on Twitch while I keep going. Introduction of Morrow, Support 5, Celerity 5, Combat 4, Spellblade 4. Introduction of Amo, White 5, Summon 5, Black 4, Bard 4. Introduction of Rig, Dragoon 5, Combat 4, 9, 4. The banner for this event features a free single poll. A couple of the Japanese Slack chat members drew 5-star relics, so don't miss your chance. Okay, Purple Nepnep says that it's Final Fantasy Dimensions in the US.
Oh, that's that app that's like a full game.
I'm actually like almost at the last boss and now I'm just playing through it. But the name doesn't ring any bell. So it's probably like the Japanese name.
No, Final Fantasy. Yeah, I know what that is.
Anyway, Dungeon Update 36 release, taking us back to Final Fantasy VIII, 13, and Tactics. Recurrence of the Japanese style DU Lucky Banner, 1 free single pull, everything else full price. Recurrence of limited time half price stamina for all story dungeon, a great chance to catch up or keep up. Nightmare Dungeon, Geo's Gaino has rotated with Gein attack, making a return. Current rooster is, or roster, I mean, Ruby Dragon from Final Fantasy VIII and Gein attack from Final Fantasy VII. Upcoming content teased via the Final Fantasy Garbage Portal app, expecting a new Final Fantasy IV event April 10th with the introduction of Ruby Kante as a playable character. Time to get your sexy on. Also expecting a bonus 10 login mitral to commemorate White Day. I didn't know what this holiday was until this
week. Oh, I know
what
that is.
But God bless Japan.
Yeah, it's essentially when after is it after or before Valentine's Day?
Well, it has to be after.
Oh, yeah, it's after Valentine's Day when the ladies pay it back to the guys. Oh, wait, no, I'm wrong. What? I'm wrong. Let's go. I forget.
Let's just move on. Can we all agree there's no way a thing called White Day could exist in America?
Yeah, it'd have to be called something different.
Okay, so let's see where we were with that. Too sorry about that. Okay, still no sight of the Final Fantasy. No, wait, I missed it. And I think that's a wrap for this week. Quite busy again with the collaboration and dungeon update built landing on the same day, so there's plenty of things to do. The good thing is this will make a lot of additional mitral available in the lead up to the next festival along the way with the White Day Logan bonuses. Still no sight of the Final Fantasy Record Keeper report. Do know that DNA will release it in a few hours and make me report it as old news next week. Do tune in next week to find out what awaits us in the unknown. As always, keep up the good work and keep saving those mithrils. There we go. So that was Japanese Week in Review. Thank you very much, Derek. For all of your hard work, much appreciated.
Thank you, Derek.
And that brings us to the segment of the show where we talk about other stuff. So let's do a quick Fire Emblem Heroes minute. There's an event that's going on.
We finally have those those transitional songs we keep talking about.
It was not what I was expecting, but always raising the bar here at Crystal Chronicles. There's an event going on called Voting Gauntlet, and I think it's called the Reddit against everybody else trashing.
Yes. Wow.
It's I picked the wrong girl, and she.
Me
is,
too.
Yeah, I pick Elise.
Oh, I'm on team Sharina. Is that her name? One of the characters from this game from the Heroes.
Yeah.
And anyway, Elise has been like destroyed really, really, really hard. So
dang.
There's something in the involvement of that game that's really losing me. So
same, honestly. I don't know what it is because the content is, you know, it's keeping up.
Yeah, it's. I don't know. It's anyway. Mobius Meta. Do we have anything?
It's Mobius Day. Yay, it's Mobius Day. I logged on and got my 100 stuff and my free stuff and my other stuff and then turned off the game.
Okay. Dang.
Play Fire Emblem Heroes.
Do we have any mobile news, Ben?
What? Stop saying no. In other Square-related news, a trailer was released for Kingdom Hearts 1.5 plus 2.5.
Who keeps making those freaking
games?
It's not 4, but it's just the PS4 compilation of all the games, 1.5. And it's running at silky smooth 60 FPS, nice. And it looks so good. And they fixed the drive form loading. It's now instantaneous. Looks so good.
Nice.
If I get a PS4, that's probably going to be the first game I get. But I need a job first.
So if you ever want to play Final Fantasy with Mickey Mouse, that is your thing.
Don't say it like it's some secret game.
That's true. Pretty much. So, yeah, Mobius still does exist. You can play it on the internet. It's amazing.
Any of you guys got a Nintendo
Switch? Switch?
Yeah,
we might be giving one away here on the Crystal.
Well, it's not going to go far. I'll grab it.
How about give it away to me?
No, you said pre-show you didn't want one. You said you wouldn't.
I said I didn't
want
to buy it. Hold on. I said I did not want to buy the console
from the drawing.
I did not want to buy the console at launch. That does not mean that I don't want the console given to me at launch. Those two are completely separate.
Yep, I've been playing my Legend of Zelda Switch Arena of Time.
Switch Arena.
That's not the title of the game. Try again.
Switch Walker.
Exhalation of the Outdoors.
Switch in Time.
All right, we're putting 5 orbs into Heroes.
Nope.
I don't know.
I did pull in Fire Emblem Heroes. I did pull Takumi, and he is level 39. I pulled him yesterday, and he's already level 39. So he levels like a crazy mofo because he's broken.
Yeah, pretty much. So what else can we talk about?
Nope. I think we're done now.
That's it? Okay.
It's done. That's shoot good. The horse.
All right. that was Crystal Chronicles, episode number 54. That's 5-4, recorded on International Women's Day of March 8, 2017. Your host tonight, we're Ben, Pierre, and Mark. If you want to reach out to us, you can do so in so many ways, one of them being by email at ffrkcentral@gmail.com. The other one being on FFRK Slack chat, which you can join easily for free at all times. It's such a great 24/7 FFRK community. For more information, go to ffrkcentral.com/FFRK chat. We are also on Facebook, search for FFRK Central. And other than that, you can reach out to us individually on the Twitters. I can be reached out at, you guessed it right, FFRK Central. If you wish to reach out to Ben, you can do so easily at.
You can find me on Twitter at etank88, where I'm going to be tweeting out a lot of Marvel related stuff. Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom 3 came out on PC, and I am getting super into that. So
it's good times.
It is. And
get your Dante on.
You can reach out to Mark at.
At Rev Mark Myers on the Twitter and at Rev HP on the Slack chats.
So we thank you very much for being with us tonight, and we will see you next Wednesday at 9 p.m. Eastern Time on twitch.tv/FFRKCentral or on your mobile device /internet/ whatever you use it to listen to us in 1 week. Thank you for being there. Have a good one. See you next week.